I'm going to get me one of those guitars and learn how to play those things. He was really kind to me. I was just a tiny little guy, and he pulled me up in his lap, and he put his guitar in front of me and sort of let me bang away on it for a while, and I was hooked. And then we grew up, and he helped me. I was kind of in a bind. I was having a hard time writing about fiction. I needed stuff to be very personal to be compelled to write about it. And he said, well, I'm going to send you this little idea that I've been working on. It's a fictional story, and let's do it together. And so we did, and it made this song. And now we try just really hard to never talk about how I used to sit in his lap. If he were here, if he hears me tell that story, he usually stands up and makes everybody be quiet, and then he tells the another story, because, you know, again, I was just a tiny little thing, and we were all at kind of a neighborhood swimming pool party, and he was being the cool older guy, and he was at the bottom of the slide that goes in the pool. He's like, go ahead, don't be scared, I'm going to catch you. And then somehow, when I landed, I lost my swimming trunks. So it just can't get any weirder. This is
what
a
way to start it off.
Yeah.
I love you, it's stronger than
near the Gulf of Mexico, on the banks of old time BP, walks an old, lost, forgotten soul. From those murky shallow waters to the pale Aegean Sea, you can hear him cry, Cecilia, come set me free, oh, come set me free. Cecilia, please come set me free. Come set me free, come set me free.
Everybody, if you got an iPhone, we're streaming live tonight, so go to YouTube, The Bottle Cap Barn Live, and tell all your friends, and they can watch it live. Right. And also, for all your newcomers, you notice we didn't take tickets when you came in. The way we do this is I'm going to pass the hat, and everybody give generously, because everything you put in there goes to the band tonight. And I wanted to tell you that in the past, in the second century.
Thank you.
lines hiding was pasted and smelled providence. Think our mind was there. When I spotted Hobbs closing the shop and sweeping up the hair beneath his chair. A bell that hung over the door announced our entrance past the close of business sign. Hobbs was covered up with holes and bleeding out when that bell rang a second time. Come on. Was my tongue that needed vengeance? Bob's ears would be my victim at night. My most loyal friend I'd ever had, cat of mine, had another plan in mind. Out here on the run with cat of mine, that we're alone, I'm scared to close my eyes. He's a dead-eyed executioner. I hope he stays forever on my side. Come on, what will you do now? Come on. When the U.S. Marshal found us, he was leering from our chase across the nation. I said, you're lucky that you found me first. His cow of mine don't care for conversation. He said, let's go get him, son. You're better off without a friend than you are dead. Just as soon as I tapped out of mine, he shot that poor marshal in the head. I swear that I was innocent, an itchy trigger fingers not to blame. It was the trigger that was itchy, and that very fact got caught in mind his name. He's my 45 revolver, whose thirst for blood has stood the test of time. With his barrel pressed against me, I suppose he's found an appetite for mine. Watching this YouTube feed, this next song, he was the only person on the planet that liked it for a long time, including himself. But he showed up at enough gigs and demanded that I play it for him that I thought to myself, I better rewrite this song or get happy with it somehow or another. I'm stuck with it. So, Pop, if you're watching, this is for you. This is called Too Soon to Say.
Thank you.
Because I was trying to lead her from the song. This is called Oh Suzanne. Speculate amongst yourselves.
It rhymes.
City lights light up the skies and sidewalks. Came on. Surely that must be where all the light goes when it gets dark back home. All the brunettes in New York City and all the hills and rain in Tennessee. We rolled through a while for what seemed like years, but I was thinking about I'm It's truly one of those life-changing kind of experiences. We were on a boat with a whole bunch of our heroes, and they're stuck on a boat with us, so they have to talk to us. And I was talking one of our friends, who's a musician as well, his name's Panda, one of the best bass players in the world, second only to Ben. I didn't say that. He's been on the boat a bunch of times, and so he called me kind of halfway through the boat. Was asking about how it was going and who we had gotten to see, and I almost felt a little gross halfway through the conversation because I was saying all these names of people that I got to meet, and I felt like I was doing that name dropping thing. And so I expressed that to Panda halfway through. I felt like I was felt a little gross about it. He kind of holds his hand up and he gets really serious in the face, and I think he's about to impart some veteran wisdom on me. And he says, "Paul McCartney told me to never drop names." But while we were on that boat, we got invited to do a Guy Clark tribute set, and it was really cool. This song is largely about the Crowell family, and I was able to look over and sing some lines that were about the Crowell family directly to Rodney Crowell, and that's one of my favorite moments I've ever had. This is the song we played, and it's called Black Diamond String. Black diamond strings, oh, black diamond strings. Drinking 1W Harper, playing black diamond strings. Black diamond strings, like a white flower in grits. He played black diamond strings, cause it's all he can get. Black diamond strings on a catalog guitar. That's pretty high cotton, whoever you are. You break one, you change one, that's as good as it gets. All year long, all to the 3 cents. J.W. Crowder was a hell of a man. He played 2 nights a week in a hillbilly band. He played at the Ice House on Telephone Road. And he played in the yard just lighting his load. Black diamond strings, oh, black diamond strings. Drinking 1W Harper, playing black diamond strings. Stretch and get a beer or get some lovely food or whatever it is that you like to do on breaks. This is a song that I wrote. I was one of those kids that grew up my whole life thinking that I was just super good at everything because my mom was just so proud of everything. And I didn't realize that she was pretending until like early adulthood. Before I realized that, I wrote this song and I thought she was going to love it so much because it mentions her in the song. She hates this song more than anything.
Tell
goes fast until dad drives like hell. When I die, my mama gets my soul. Here I'm fading just for the daylight, and I still don't know what will come to collect me, which way will
thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
right, everybody, come on in and get settled in. We're getting ready to start the second set here. We got a few announcements to make, so come on in. All right, everybody on the food side, I know you can hear this. Come on in here. I want you to get up and talk about who's coming next. So it wouldn't be polite not to mention a few of the people that help put together all of this all the time, and they're always relentless in their help. Joe Bailey back here does sound, and he actually comes out all the time and helps put a lot of this stuff together. And Ben Scott is a good friend of ours. And, you know, he's kind of the original culprit between him and my wife Alicia that actually made all this start. That's a whole other story 8-9 years ago. So, and I don't know, is Lance still here? Lance Leitner still here? Just want to thank Lance. He's kind of the nerd that does all the video stuff that puts us on the internet. He doesn't mind being called that because he's a great guy. He comes out and helps him build stuff too. And so we've got like a whole bunch of people here locally that just put a lot of energy into this. And, you know, we get done at the end of the night, come get up tomorrow morning, there's basically nothing left to do because everybody picks up and cleans up and takes care of stuff. And we really appreciate that. We're really glad there's so many new people here tonight. How many people are here for the first time? I mean, is that not cool? Every time there's somebody new. In fact, there's people here that came for the first time that came up to me and they're looking at me like behind my ear. They're like, is that you, Ben? I go, well, yeah. They go, well, you did my landscaping 17 years ago. I was like, oh, God, really? So, I mean, isn't that cool? So there's all kinds of people that show up. And my folks who live in Chicago are watching live. Hey, Mom and Dad. They're not able to travel anymore. They're 87 years old, and they love music. They've been down here, and our friends and all of us have jammed with them. And so when they get a chance, they'll watch us live, and there's a lot of people that don't get an opportunity. And so we really thank Lance for being able to bring this live on YouTube, or you can go to any of our old shows. Even these guys are on there from the last show they were here, so, and the show before that. So I'm going to have Alicia basically talk about some of the next shows that are coming up. And then we're going to introduce a little lady that's going to come up here, because there's also another concert series that goes on in Oklahoma just up the street in Perkins that we're going to introduce you to, and she's going to talk a little bit about it. So, well, no choice, she's got to it. Another musician in the crowd, Monica Taylor, yeah, she's going to come up and talk in a little bit. So at least she's going to tell you about what's coming up here.
The next show is April 1st, it's Kyle Reed, and my voice is just about gone. It's Kyle Reed and Andy Adams, and they're going to be here, and it's a fundraising endeavor for them to make their next album. So we'd love to have you guys come out on April 1st and help them do that. They're Oklahoma musicians, and they're just fabulous men, fabulous guys. So, Monica, do you want to talk about this a minute? We have a good friend, Monica Taylor. I know a lot of you heard of her music. Do you want to tell us what this is, darling? Okay.
Howdy, y'all. How you doing? It's good to see y'all. I was here played after Thanksgiving with the Red Dirt Rangers and had a wonderful time. It was so much fun. And Ben and Alicia come over to Perkins and help out with our concert series called the Cimarron Breeze Concerts. And we just had Wink Bertram and Jacob Tovar last Friday night, Joan Fulbright, and it was so much fun. But we have a fundraising gala dinner show with Gypsy Jazz and Bluegrass and such, March 31st, and it's going to be catered and wonderful music. And
the food is delicious.
We have some tickets for that, I guess, here. So. And there's a poster inside on the refrigerator with all of our new shows. So hope to see you up there. It's not far. Thank you.
And June 3rd, we have Bob Livingston, Cowboys and Indians. And I don't know. I think that's it for right now. So anyway, enjoy the rest of your evening and enjoy the Mulligan Brothers. Thank you.
And don't forget, if you just got here, we still have a hat up here, so please donate generously to the band up here with the hat. So, all right, back to the stage. The Mulligan Brothers and Sis.
So, all of you know Ben and Alicia now, and you know just how special they are. This whole thing, they built this place so we, all of us, could be here. We'll never be able to thank you guys.
Just like some tiny Texas oil man struck oil in my eyes. I would always be just kidding there as long as I stayed. With enough well wishes from back home, enough state lines away. I would just walk under a spotlight in a dark and crowded room and say hello. My name is Kate. Who are you? You would all say. This is somewhere, and I'm somebody, and now so are you, so are you. Now Katie walks a beat across the sea of her dreams, alone and scared of everyone to fall in her shame. Speaking with
you.
reflectors in the middle of the road. I guess I became a danger and all my friends became strangers. I was feeling as cold as a home, as a new lover's hell, and I could already tell that I wasn't going home. Something God made, even if it hurts sometimes. I wanna live, and not in a long way, even if it's hard This is a song about creepy style jealousy. This guy is called a love song. By request, I believe. So here you go.
You have to be more
specific. I think coincidentally we were about to play that song. Anyway. Requested times two. are just about to release a live album that we recorded.
Oh, thanks.
We were in the Netherlands in October, part of November, and we recorded all the shows there, and we're just getting all that stuff organized. I think within the next few weeks we'll be releasing that live album, and we decided on the way in to maybe pick up some cover songs that we could sort of put our stink on, and this is one of the ones we picked. It's a weird choice.
It's a Thomas Dolby song.
I'm not afraid to die.
the drums. Decisions, and they were premature, those decisions I was about to make. met this guy who had made similar decisions, and I got to see what happens to a fellow when he makes those decisions. I decided to pump the brakes a little. So I'm grateful for him, wherever he's at. This is called Ghost Door Suit.
Get home from me. Oh, to you in the first set, or did you not love any in the first set? four of whatever she's having.
Struggles up here. So we actually played in the Netherlands in October, November-ish, and we recorded our shows live. So we're going to be releasing a CD, actually a double disc CD, pretty soon, live from the Netherlands, and this is on it. Yes?
Yes.
Yes. everybody look what's going down.
You guys have just been amazing. Thank you so much again for being here and supporting such a cool thing, and for your company, and for letting us look at you for this long time. You're all good.
Anytime. Anytime.
We're going to do this one, and then we're going to try to start getting a little bit out of the way. If you've been here before, you know that the fun part happens when we stop. So don't go anywhere, and just thank you again so much. We're incredibly grateful to get to spend our lives around people like you. Thank you.
September we walked across the boardwalk to that smoky bar. I've been singing for the last 6 nights. I couldn't bear to talk to tell you just how pretty you were, but you were as pretty as a preacher's wife on Sunday. I was useless like a church bell on a Friday night. I felt like a tragedy all dressed in dirty clothes when you walked out before I could say how we used to get in the world. I gotta let you know just how I used to have things for the boys. The only thing I know, won't you just stay here? Won't you just stay here? You can just stay here. You can just stay here.
Spent the whole next night on the telephone, and we were both alone. Change. I remember I felt as suave as a prom date. 15 minutes later, it ensued his mother's call. Next time was a Monday, and you came over my house. We hardly talked about anything, but it never got quiet till we kissed our first of many, and the clock hands took a break from the round the clock labor of their day to day. 'Cause when you stop in the world, it's nice for me.
Just stay, 'cause we
walked across the boardwalk to that smoky bar.
Nobody knows it better than me. Yeah, I wouldn't be.
for love.
Like a vice, Lord.